Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kita akan bercakap tentang Koros Vertex 2. Malam ini kita akan ada special guest di mana aku pun last minute panggil special guest ni. So kita ada special guest yang di mana dia merupakan salah seorang ambassador kepada Koros. Actually kita ada dua ambassador Koros malam ini untuk bincang dengan kita orang. Dan juga kita ada seorang special guest untuk bercerita tentang jam yang akan kita bercakap, iaitu Koros Vertex. Ini merupakan jam Koros Vertex, ramai orang yang dah tahu. So sebelum apa-apa, aku just nak tunjuk dekat semua orang. Terima kasih kepada siapa yang join. Pasal hari ini merupakan first time juga. Hai Azwan, first time juga kita orang buat live dekat YouTube. Okay, because sebelum ni kita orang buat live dekat Facebook. So ini merupakan first time live dekat YouTube. Jadi untuk tidak lengah lagi, aku akan tunjuk kotak. Ini merupakan kotak Koros Koros Vertex 2, di mana bila beli saja jam ini akan dapat casing macam ni. Okay, ni cara buka dia. Alright, so dia kat dalam ni tak ada lah. Inilah dia. Alright, so sekarang casing dia ni hard case, memang bagus. So bila korang beli akan dapat casing ni. Aku akan tunjuk lah untuk korang eh. Oh Ajay, apa khabar? Okay, jangan lupa share dekat kawan-kawan korang dekat Facebook semua, because ini merupakan first time kita orang live dekat YouTube. Pasal ini di request oleh pihak Koros lah. Okay, anyway, aku tunjuk. Ini merupakan user manual guide macam biasa. Tapi yang dahsyatnya ada stiker dan juga ada, mana dia? Mana dia brother ni? Okay, tertinggal. Okay, ada Eliud Kipchoge. Okay, so diorang menggunakanlah dia sebagai ambassador dan stiker reflective explore perfection. So aku agak suka dia tak adalah besar macam dulu. Dulu kalau Koros punya Vertex punya ni besar gedabak. Dia macam boleh simpan senapang. So ini kecil. Ni macam lunchbox pada. So macam kau boleh ni tutup dan juga lock. Okay, so ini merupakan box yang korang akan dapat. Dan ini merupakan kotak dia. Okay, ini merupakan kotak yang kita akan dapat. Huh, jongket pada. Oh, bob bear pada. Alright. So, untuk mengatakan sekarang, this is edisi Asia ataupun dihantarkan kepada Asia. Di Malaysia ada dua orang yang dapat jam ini. Salah seorang ialah aku. Dan lagi seorang ialah Al-Rumi. So dia pun sekarang tengah live menceritakan tentang benda yang sama, iaitu Koros Vertex. Hi Atreyu, apa khabar? Okay, so macam aku kata tadi, first time kita live di YouTube. Terima kasih kepada korang yang follow dan juga tengok kita orang di YouTube. Dengar aku clear ke tak? Okay, sambil tu aku ulang balik. Kita juga ada special guest, pasal aku tak nak cakap sorang-sorang macam orang gila. So apa-apa pun, ini merupakan jam yang terbaru, baru keluar. Okay, iaitu Vertex. Okay, Vertex ni, okay aku akan tunjuk in detail. Untuk mengatakan korang, aku akan tunjuk in detail macam mana bentuk dia. Aku tukar kamera sikit. Okay, so ini merupakan jam dia. Okay. So ini widget dia ataupun kau boleh dia ada knob kat sini. Kalau tengok balik dari segi design dia, okay. Ini tak ada sekali. Ini bagi aku penutup. Penutup untuk charging port dia. Charging port ni bagi aku kena ada tutup. Kalau tak, karat. So sebaik-baiknya kalau korang ada, ini aku ambil daripada aku punya version sebelum ni untuk cover supaya tak tak basah ataupun karat lah. Okay. Anyway, dia datang macam ni. Dan juga the best thing about Koros is dia punya strap ni. Dia punya strap ni sangat mudah. Kau boleh tekannya, dah boleh buka. Okay. So that is how it works lah. Okay. Sambil tu, sambil-sambil aku pasang balik. Tengok kau. Tak nampak tak tak. Okay. Sambil-sambil aku pasang balik. Sekejap eh. Dia kena nampak tu ni. Amat rabun. Okay. So, dari segi design dia, kalau korang tengok, dia colour orange. Dia ada dua colour actually. Nanti aku akan tunjuk. Dan sini agak kasar, which is good. Material dia sangat, orang kata apa, macam biasalah. Yang siapa-siapa yang pakai Koros sebelum ni dapat tahu. Kemudian dia punya satu benda yang aku nampak dari segi design yang aku suka ialah kat sini ada logo Koros tepi ni. Nampak tak? Nampak eh. Okay. Alright. So knob dia pula very smooth. Kalau kau tengok bila aku pusing macam ni. Okay, knob dia. Very smooth knob dia. Okay, itu merupakan dari segi design je. Okay, dah tengok dari design je. Kemudian dia punya watch face ni pun baru. Dan other than that, dari segi design, aku suka pasal it's very simple dan juga mercik lah kalau rain. Okay, seterusnya, sebelum itu, aku nak tengok siapa ada. Oh, Safri. Apa khabar, Safri? Okay. Untuk korang yang live sekarang ni, sambil-sambil aku mencerita point ni, korang kena dengar point aku. Pasal apa? Nanti kita akan bagi hadiah iaitu topi ataupun cap Koros. Okay, kita ada 5 giveaway untuk korang. So, jangan lupa korang stay tune dan juga make sure korang tahu apa yang kita orang akan bercakap sekejap lagi lah. Okay. Point seterusnya, selepas dari segi design kita tengok, iaitu tadi aku dah tunjuk juga interface dia. Macam mana interface dia tadi kan, kalau korang tengok tadi. Kemudian aku akan bercakap tentang map dia. Okay. Map dia dekat sini. Okay. Sekali lagi aku akan tunjuk map. Okay. Ini merupakan map dia. Sekejap eh. Aku tekan dulu. Okay. So dekat sini, bila press lama-lama kat sini. Okay, dekat ni button back. Ini button lampu. So ini button scroll knob lah. So Allah susah lah pula. Okay. So bila kita tekan back lama-lama, dia akan keluar macam ni. Okay, bila tekan dalam map. So ini map yang aku pilih ni ialah hybrid. Eh bukan, sorry. Ini topo. Tadi aku pakai hybrid. So contoh dia sekarang ni. Map ni dia tengah update ataupun location mana yang kita ada. Dia akan tunjuk all the trails. Okay, sorry korang kena sengit. Aku pun tak sedar. Okay, so dia akan baca all the locations lah. Nampak tu? So ada topo map dekat situ. So kita boleh pilih tiga benda untuk pilihan dia. Tak silap aku pilihan dia. Sekejap eh. Bagi aku check dulu dia ada pilihan dia. Okay. Okay, dia ada topo, landscape dan juga hybrid. So tiga pilihannya tu. Kemudian jam ini memang sesuai untuk rock climbing, trail running, hiking dan juga cycling. Okay, sambil-sambil tu, sambil-sambil aku nak bercerita tentang orang kata apa, dia punya topo dan sebagainya. Sambil itu juga aku nak tunjuk kat korang, nak cerita korang pasal GN, sorry, mana dia eh. Okay. Sambil-sambil tu aku nak tunjuk kat korang bahawa dia punya screen ni ialah 1.4 inch touch screen. Okay, kenapa dia touch screen? Pasal tadi kan aku ambil benda ni kan. Sekejap eh, tunjuk. So nampak ni boleh bergerak. Maksudnya boleh touch. So untuk map macam ni kita boleh gerak-gerakkan dia, tapi dia agak slow pasal dia tengah loading untuk cari dia punya GPS lah. Okay, kemudian cerita tentang GPS pula untuk pengetahuan korang semua. GPS ni pula, okay, GPS ni pula mana dia eh? Sekejap, sementara tu. Okay, aku nak cerita pasal GPS dengan GNSS. Okay, GPS dengan GNSS ni merupakan Global Navigation Satellite System. Okay, itu GNSS. GPS ialah Global Positioning System. Untuk pengetahuan korang, aku ada seorang rakan yang tahu tentang benda-benda ini yang boleh membantu akulah dari segi teknikal dan juga benda-benda jam ni. Aku akan menjemput seorang rakan iaitu nama dia Afendi. Okay. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Afendi.
Yo yo, dengar.
Apa khabar?
Khabar baik.
Okay. So, sekarang aku tadi baru cakap pasal size of the screen tadi. Dia 1.4. One of the biggest dalam Coros punya jam. Gedabak lah. Dia lagi besar daripada Phoenix, tak silap aku.
Ya, yeah, betul.
Kan? So, macam kau sendiri yang selalu review jam, is it a good thing ada besar ke is a bad thing ada screen yang besar?
Kalau dah ada topo max, screen besar tu sangat memainkan peranan lah. Sebab kita nak senang nak zoom in, nak zoom out. And then kita punya view tu lagi cantik lah, lagi besar. So membantulah. Kalau kecil sangat nanti susah nak zoom dan tak nampak lah detail.
Macam tadi aku boleh touch tu something yang bagus ke tak? Especially kalau macam tengah lari ke apa ke, is it practical ke apa kau rasa? Maksudnya macam patutnya pakai knob saja ke better ataupun okay dia pakai touch screen?
Dia dua-dua option bagus lah, tapi ikut situasi. Kalau macam tangan kotor, maybe kita boleh pakai tombol tu. Kalau tangan kita bersih, kering, kita boleh pakai zoom tu. Tengok mana lagi cepat lah. Tapi aku rasa kalau ikut zoom, pakai tangan lah. Pusing tombol tu agak lambat sedikit lah.
Okay. So, kalau macam tangan ada nasi lemak, tak boleh lah.
Makan dulu, baru zoom.
Kan? Memang habis lah. Lepas tu macam tadi aku bercerita juga pasal satellite GNSS. Kita ada banyak satellite kan? Boleh tak kau cerita sikit tentang beberapa satellite? Aku tahu tapi just nak kau punya input jugalah.
Dia sebenarnya yang aku tahu setakat ni ada 5 dia sokongan dia. GPS, QZSS, lepas tu dia ada Galileo, ni terbarulah untuk Coros. Sebab sebelum ni kalau model-model Coros yang lain tak ada Galileo tau. So untuk yang Vertix tu ni dia bagi Galileo. So macam bagus lah sebab kita dah ada option lagi satu. And then last kali ada Beidou yang satelit pada China. Dan bila banyak satelit ni kita ada option lah. And then benda ni kena try and error ikut condition. Kalau macam korang lari kat kawasan tu, GPS yang apa satelit yang macam ni tak okay, korang ada option lain untuk try lah. Then in fact yang baru diorang ada dual GPS punya sistem yang mana dia boleh pair dengan lagi banyak satelit dalam satu masa. Kalau sebelum ni maybe 2 atau 1 ikut condition, tapi sekarang ni dia allow 5-5. Dia akan betul connect mana satu yang okay. So dekat sini GPS punya line tu lagi cantik lah.
Betul. So Afendi dah pecah rahsia. Cie. Memang itu merupakan features yang terbaru. Dan aku rasa kalau siapa yang tengok semalam live, tahulah bahawa dia punya satellite dan juga features dia kita boleh buat dual, which is dia boleh buat dua sekali kan tadi. Selalunya dia boleh pilih satu saja. Maksudnya macam Galileo, dia satellite ni ada banyak-banyak satellite. Ada yang dari Russia, daripada China, daripada UK. Galileo tu UK ke apa? Tak ingat dah. So macam
Euro punya.
Euro punya dah. So all these satellite, untuk mengatakan korang, dia berguna especially bila kita dekat bangunan tinggi-tinggi dan juga dalam trails lah, macam tempat yang susah lah. Macam pengalaman kau sendiri, Fendi, aku nampak kau berlari mengata-kata pakai 2-3 jam kan, orang tak kata gila ke apa ke? Macam mana perasaan tu?
Nak kata gila tak agak, sebab kadang aku lari sorang-sorang tengah hari orang tak nampak.
Oh, tak nampak pakai 2 jam lah.
And then aku kadang sampai 4 lah. 4
paling banyak sekali lari kau pakai 4?
5 kot. 4 jam satu iPhone. So aku memang try GPS lah semua, mana satu yang okey.
Okey. Untuk mengatakan korang semua, Afendi memang suka memang buat review untuk jam-jam dan juga dia dah try banyak jam in one time. So even dari segi location apa semua, dia try GPS semua. Dalam banyak GPS, apa GPS yang kau suka?
GPS plus GLONASS, sebab aku rasa setakat ni yang dekat Malaysia, yang tu paling stable lah. Sebab yang tu pun default kita pakai. Bukan nak kata yang lain ni tak okay. Dia ikut condition. Sebab satelit ni pun dia ikut availability dia. Kadang satelit ni ada yang tak aktif. That's why ada features satelit info dekat Koros. So sebelum katalah korang nak lari, yang gambar tadi tu, korang boleh tengok tau berapa banyak satelit yang available dekat situ. So kalau macam okay, bedu kurang, jangan pakai pairing yang bedu. Korang pilih lah, jangan GLONASS ke. Dekat situ ada information dia. Kalau macam GL tak silap aku, GLONASS, QZ, QZ SS tu Jepun punya tak silap aku. So daripada situ kita tengok condition dekat tempat tu, yang mana paling banyak, kita try yang tu. Tapi untuk default, kalau malas nak fikir, ambil GPS plus GLONASS lah. Itu yang paling default untuk Malaysia lah, biasa pakai.
Alright. So itu soalan jawapan yang telah diberikan. Pada ada orang tanya harga berapa, untuk pengetahuan korang, harga tu kejap lagi aku akan beritahu. Cih. Sambil-sambil tu, okay, sambil-sambil tu kita akan juga bagi topi secara percuma, dan aku juga akan personally akan bagi satu topi kepada siapa yang tanya soalan dekat kita orang. Kalau kita orang tak ada jawab tu, memang aku akan bagi lah, confirm. Okay, tanya soalan yang paling susah pun tak apa, tapi soalan mengenai jam lah. Okay, so jangan tanya pasal Afendi single ke apa ke, janganlah.
Ush.
Okay, anyway, so move on. Dah selepas dari segi tu, itu merupakan satu benda. Koros dikenali juga dengan dia punya, orang kalau sebut Koros satu benda je, iaitu battery life. Ini merupakan battery life yang telah di-upgradekan pada Vertix, which is jam inilah. Okay. Sambil-sambil tu aku akan tunjuk orang the details of the jam. Dia tak tunjuk pun bateri mana. Tapi masa aku dapat jam ni, untuk mengatakan orang baru berapa hari saja sebenarnya. So bateri dia sekarang kalau korang tengok dekat bawah ni ialah 84% lah. Aku just quick glance, 84%. Masa yang aku dapat pun 90%. So aku tak buat banyak benda sangat pun, dan orang kata apa, daily punya benda, dan aku tukar tracking dia supaya full saja, nak full blast tengok kan. So berapa persen saja dia turun. Macam jam-jam lain, yang pernah aku pakai sebelum ni, aku kena bawa power bank. Mana power bank aku dah? Okay. Power bank aku memang besar gedabak, so dia susah bila lari masuk dalam vest ke lari ultra ke apa, kena charge and then ni kena cabut tak kat luar. Salah satu benda yang aku sedar pasal Koros ni, aku pernah bawa power bank hari tu tapi tak guna pun sebenarnya. Pasal dia punya battery life memang tahan lama. So sekarang ni dia telah ada battery life dia sekarang ialah dalam 140 untuk standard, iaitu standard GPS biasa. Okay. Kemudian apa lagi? Standard full GPS dengan music 35 jam, all system 90 dan sistem dengan music 30 jam juga. Okay, music ni pula, kenapa kalau korang sedar kat tepi ni, aku ada aku punya AirPod ni. Okay, sambil-sambil tu aku akan tunjuk. Bukan tunjuk lah, malas tunjuk. Dia ada juga dekat sini kalau kau press and hold. Pilih dekat sini, atas ni. Ni Ultra Max. Metronome. Battery, ni battery usage. Tu kejap lagi aku akan cerita gambar music ni. Okay. So music ni, kau boleh main music. So tetapi dia akan connect kepada aku punya earbud lah. Okay. Kemudian dia punya music pula store dekat dalam melalui komputer untuk store kat dalam jam ni. So that is the features of the music lah. The kelemahan dia, dia tak ada Spotify ataupun Apple Play. So that is it lah. Macam Afendi, kau dah guna jam-jam lain kan? Apa pendapat kau tentang orang kata the features music yang ada dekat dalam Vertix sekarang ni?
Okay, features music Aku rasa aku sebenarnya tak jangka tau Koros nak bagi features music ni dekat Vertix tu, sebab macam terlalu awal, sebab macam quite shock lah. Sebelum ni kita tahu satu brand je yang ada, and then suddenly Koros buat, and macam wow, dengan ada music tapi bateri dia tak terganggu sangat, memang serious game changing lah benda ni. Yep. Sebab biasanya kalau kita ada lagu, dia takkan tahan lebih pada satu hari tau, which is 24 jam lah. Tapi untuk Koros ni, full GPS, dual punya sistem, boleh tahan 25 jam. So macam, okay. Maksudnya kau nak dengar lagu sepanjang event pun boleh. Cuma tak advisable lah untuk dengar lagu masa on game kan.
Tapi ada kot orang yang sanggup punya tu.
Kalau looping punya game, no hal, boleh dengar lagu. Tapi kalau in trail lah, better avoid lah. Tapi kemampuan jam ni, serius macam, okay, aku macam impressed gila lah.
Okay. Macam tadi aku tunjuk battery life tu macam mana? Apa cakap kau pasal battery life? Memang ada yang lain boleh boleh lawan dia ke macam mana?
Setakat ni rasanya tak ada kot. Last Garmin Enduro dia buat lebih kurang 1 bulan lebih macam tu lah. Tapi bila keluar yang ni 60 hari dalam smartwatch punya mode, weh, kabel pun boleh hilang kan macam ni. 60 hari kot.
Tapi betul. Bagi aku pun macam charging, kalau even buat aktiviti pun sampai boleh terlupa. Sampai orang kata apa, jam ni it's very, orang kata apa, melalaikan kita lah. Lepas tu sambil-sambil tu aku tunjuk kat sini contohnya heart rate ke apa kan. Koros, Apex dan juga Vertix ni dia ada macam touch screen, dia boleh macam move macam ni. So bagi akulah, it helps juga macam kau kata tadi, kalau tangan ada nasi kandar ke apa tak boleh lah kot kalau orang kata apa penuh dengan ni kan. So susahlah nak touch. Okay. Tapi dari segi nak tengok tu, it's a good thing jugalah supaya kita boleh scroll. Yeah. Jadi aku tak pakai jari tak apa, pakai knob pun okay. aku jenis a knob kind of person. Aku suka yang jenis guna knob.
Rasa macam mati.
Rasa benda. Bila kau bong kan, macam penat nak lari-lari, kau kena touch something yang infinite. Kalau tak benda tu macam tak ada benda, rasa macam betul ke aku sentuh ni kan? Tak bergerak-gerak pun. Mulalah kau tak puas hati apa semua kan. So that is how aku punya cara lah. Sambil-sambil tu, okay, kita akan ada lagi seorang. Aku akan jemput salah seorang daripada kita punya ambassador untuk bercakap pasal salah satu yang jam yang ada touch screen, iaitu daripada jauh lah orang ni. Aku kejap aku panggil orang ni. So ambassador Koros yang akan aku panggil ini, dia berada jauh, bukan di Malaysia. So aku ingin menjemput Alison. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, you like operator pengeluar lah.
I at work what?
Okay. Hi Alison. Meet Effendi. This is Alison.
Hi.
So hi. Alison.
Yes.
What watch are you using right now?
I'm using Apex Pro.
Okay, there is a feature, touchscreen. Tell us about it.
So if you go on the map. Wait. Let me find map first. So when you go on the map, wait ah. So if I just open the map, can you see? This is the current watch,
Okay.
Can you see? So if you want to see a different part of the map, you can just move. You can just move the screen using your finger. And then you can expand also.
Okay. So is it easier for you to maneuver or to navigate?
I don't really use the I normally when I start the workout, right, I make sure the zoom is correct, and then so you don't have to move the thing much. Do you understand?
I think so. Other than that,
if you get lost, then you can just move the screen easier with your finger, except when it's raining, then it's not so good. But if it's sunny day and you want to quickly move it, then it's easier to move than trying to play with the button.
But like over there in UK, right, the weather, how's the weather there? I mean, is it easier for you to maneuver it, like navigate it?
Most days it's okay, but when it's raining, then it's not so good lah. But
so the sensor, is it that sensitive or how is it?
It works well enough. It's not too sensitive. So if you put the screen on, and it's raining, right, the screen won't move.
I see.
It's only if you use your finger, then you will move.
Okay. So at the same time, the features in Apex Pro and Apex, we will call another person, okay, which is our another ambassador. His name is Ray Randy.
Hello. Hey guys.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
Okay, so Ray, you have been using Koros Apex for quite some time, right?
Yeah.
So now we have a Koros Apex user and also a Koros Apex Pro user.
Yeah, so I've been using Apex 46 millimeter for the past, I think, almost a year plus. So it's been great, because before this I was using the Pace, and then they upgraded me to Apex 46 millimeter. I also tried the 42 millimeter from a friend of mine. It suits if you have a smaller hand or a smaller wrist, 42 will be great, but 46 is a good size as well, but the most important features that I like from the watch is the battery life, you know. So yeah.
All right. Okay, we have a question. Kalau on GPS, adakah akan bergerak Mars atau tak? Sebab brand lagi apa ni? Fendi, boleh tolong baca tak? Aku tak nampak sangat.
Kalau on GPS dalam rumah, adakah akan bergerak Mars atau tak? Sebab brand lagi 1G, kalau on GPS berlari indoor, dia tak detect langsung. Basically kalau lari indoor, GPS connection patutnya off lah. Jangan pakai GPS punya ni, outdoor run ke run biasa, pakai run indoor. Sebab indoor kan GPS ni dekat atas. So kita kena clear sky untuk dapat connection dia. So kalau dalam rumah, memang by logicnya memang tak boleh lah. Dan korang akan menunggu GPS tu connected. Memang takkan connected.
Itu memang semua sama kan jamnya tu?
Ah, semua sama.
Okay, macam Jongkit tanya, ada metronom? Memang ada metronom. Most of the jam ada. Apex ada metronom tak, Ray?
Ada. I use it once in a while for the cadence training. Yeah. I think most of it have the metronom.
How about Alison, are you using metronome for your training?
My cadence is always 180, so I don't need to train.
Whoa! Okay, terbaik. So, anyway, Alison, you know that we have launched the latest watch from Vertix, right? Do you have anything to ask about the watch first before I proceed to anything else?
No, because I think a lot of the features, because it's Coros, a lot of the features will be coming to the Apex Pro as well. So
yes, correct. That is one thing that I'm going there actually, because macam apa yang Addison kata, apa yang ada dekat Vertix 2 ni, dia akan pergi ke Apex Pro ke atas. Okay, Apex Pro ke atas. So Apex tak ada lah hari kan?
Tak ada, memang you cannot fit the map inside the Apex.
Yeah, yes. I think the capacity is too small.
One thing about Coros watch that I noticed is how to transfer the GPX. It's very quick and efficient. What do you guys think? I mean, to transfer GPX map to the watch.
Yeah, everything's on the phone. What? So you just download GPX, you book out on the phone, and then it's automatic load. What?
Yes. So it's kind of easy, right?
Yeah.
Few steps only. It's quite convenient. Really easy.
Okay, so tadi Atreyu tanya kalau jari berpeluh, what is the sensitive level of the touch? How about this one? That's why I want to ask Alison. If let's say you lari dekat sana, like all the weather, you know, basah and muddy and everything, does it affect?
Not really. No, it's only when you touch it. Then it will react. But sometimes if it's raining and you're touching it, sometimes it's a bit hard. It might not react fast enough. But if you clean the screen, then you move, then it's okay.
Okay. Nice.
So, yeah. So as in, when you're looking at the map, it won't just lari lah. You know, sometimes you know with your phone, then it just move until you cannot see the map.
Ghost touch.
But this one this one is okay. I haven't had any problems yet lah, but you know UK raining every day, right? So.
So, how about Ray? Macam for you when you run with the watch, what are the best features for you?
I think again coming from the battery itself, we have the breadcrumb using Apex that help a lot, and then they give you the warning when you're off course. That actually saved a couple of times when I was running in UTOP, Penang, 2019. I got lost a few times, and you know, they give me a warning, like, you know, hey, turn back. And then also when I was running in Bromo, they also gave me a few warning, because there's a lot of like different paths, you know. So sometimes when you're running at night, you cannot really see which one is the way. So yeah, they, I think that's one of the main point as well. But for Vertix 2, I'm really looking forward for the battery life, because it is like, it's 4 times longer compared to Apex, you know, 140 hour full GPS battery.
Yes.
It's like lasts you for like 5 to 6 days, you know. It's a good, it's a good full expedition for like a week. Really excited for that one.
All right. Like for Apex Pro, what do you have any problems with the battery?
No, I haven't tested it to flat yet, so I haven't run long enough for it to flat yet. So
but you can run that long.
Yeah,
I go on holiday, but I don't bring my charger. So
ayo, then it's still okay, right?
Yeah, still okay. And I because nowadays I go holiday in the Lake District very often, so it's mostly mountain running, and no need to charge. I put GPX on, no problem.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. Usually that's the case also, right? When I'm like, when we're doing racing on the weekend, just leave the charger at home.
Yeah, not like all the Garmin user all bring charger. Charger, wire everywhere.
Yes. But I think last time also I saw Randy run at UTOP. I don't know whether he's using what watch at time, but that time I was using another watch, Garmin watch, and then I have to bring a charger lah, basically, and put it in the bag.
Yeah, because I feel like with Coros, like, I know I'm ambassador and everything, but I feel like whenever they advertise the battery life, that's the minimum. Whereas usually Garmin, they give you the hours, right? That's the maximum. Because before I used Coros, I used Garmin, and they say maximum, the they say, oh, it's 24 hours. But when I ran my 24-hour race at 21 hours, mati. So, yeah.
Okay, for this is another question. Kalau pakai glove, touchscreen okay tak?
Haven't try lah, belum winter ma.
Have anyone try lah? Macam Effendi pernah try?
Tak pernah.
Tak pernah lah.
Soon winter, I try and let you know.
Tapi as long rasa aku kalau jari kau panas, still boleh move lagi. Sebab it's not really touchscreen punya ni, tapi boleh slide lah.
Boleh lah move tu actually. Okay. Wah, ni soalan Abang Khalis. Untuk Vertix 2, ada turn by turn navigation tak?
It depends on the GPX file, right? Because if the GPX file have turn by turn, then yes. But I know that a lot of ultras, they don't do turn by turn, right? So it depends on the file, if I'm not wrong.
That's the thing. Because tadi pun I tak sempat try. Actually, I did try it. So, question ni sangat bagus lah. I sendiri, my personal views, even I use Apex Pro before this. Have you encountered that? Macam FND, pernah encounter tak?
10x10 navigation lah. Rasanya tak ada.
They have the arrow, but they don't beep at you. So if you look at the GPX file, and then they will show the arrow on like the turn, but it doesn't beep.
Because actually, I think I saw it in some somebody's YouTube. I can't remember. They say that it doesn't affect that much. That's what I think. Itu answer dia lah. Tapi itulah. Aku sendiri tak berani nak bagi tahu is betul ke tak. Because aku sendiri tak try lagi. But setahu my point of view, like what Alison said lah. Jarang guna kan? Should be lah. Okay. So, satu soalan yang bagus, Khalis, aku akan bagi kau topi Coros. Pasal aku ada tanda tanya pasal that kind of question. Okay. So, Khalis, tolong DM aku di Pelari Denai. ambil details dan tahniah giveaway pertama. Alright. Oh ya, ada soalan lagi. Okay. There's another question. Once kita upload GPX Mac to Coral Vertex 2, boleh tak Coral bagi tahu ETA estimate arrival on points on distance? Semua ada kan, basically?
Tak tahu leh. Because Apex Pro don't have.
Tak ada.
Apex Pro only tell you how many miles left. So if you press on the navigation, it'll tell you how many miles to end, but it doesn't tell you the estimated time.
But if I'm not mistaken, from the GPX file itself, if let's say lah, the GPX file, dia akan bagi tahu estimation juga. It depends on that GPX that you save lah. Meaning if let's say you save the GPX, the estimation let's say 20 minutes, orang tu dah buat, that person did. So we get that numbering lah. The ETA.
I don't think got ETA.
But the Vertex tu, myself pun tak check lagi sama ada ke tak. Ray, what do you think?
So far for Apex, they only give us the kilometer left, like how many kilometers.
Yeah. Don't have estimated.
Don't have
time.
The ETA.
Hmm.
But when you upload the GPX file, they do give the previous time lah, how long that.
Betul. Yeah. Betul. So that's what I meant lah. Meaning the previous time ya dia kan. But
kalau but I know what he asking though. I know the question because if you use other watches right, like Garmin or whatever, they will tell you based on your pace what they think you will finish the race in, but
yes, correct.
But how you want to tell what is guessing, right? Like it's never accurate, what? So
yes, actually the answer for this is okay. I tunjuk this one lah. The answer for this is this one. This is yang ada dekat Coros, the latest one. I think Apex Pro atas kot.
Yeah,
ada Evo Lab.
I think Apex pun ada mah. I think Evo Lab is
semua ada.
So semua ada. So basically Evo Lab ni dia akan tell us about your performance jugalah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it doesn't calculate the ETA.
Yeah. It give you the race predictor lah. How long, like after your training, tell you like how long you're going to finish the 5K, 10K.
But so far Evo Lab doesn't calculate your trail runs.
Yeah.
At this moment.
It's only on road run.
Yeah.
So
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Next one. Just now tadi I ada cakap because this Vertex dia support music. It's only supported MP3 untuk pengetahuan korang. And dia juga support Insta360. I don't have Insta360 right now.
Mahal eh.
So tapi dia punya control pun not that much. It's just like, you know, you can record it, that's it. But it's something new for Coros lah. So you can control. Dengan harapan in the future, maybe kalau boleh control GoPro pun bagus juga. Okay, so next question. Ada orang tanya soalan lagi. Apa ni? Soalan baik. Oh, ETA tu waste. Okay, compatibility Insta360 kamera ke bang? Betul lah, kamera. Compatibility dengan kamera. Insta360 semua kamera? Bukan semua kamera. GoPro semua tak boleh. Insta360 je. So, yang itu aku tak ada. Berapa capacity music boleh masuk? MP3 dia tak besar pun because dia punya size ni pun berapa saja.
32 GB,
tapi for me janganlah letak banyak music. Dan lagi satu MP3 pun
kalau ikut dengan korang dia.
Macam default dia pun sekarang ada berapa lagu? 5 lagu je. Lagu pun lagu biasa-biasa je. Then macam, okay, Afendi boleh cerita pasal dia punya music in smartwatches ni? From your point of view.
Okay, untuk size tu depends dengan korang punya MP3 quality lah. Kalau macam 128 bit, lagi rendah lah. Kalau pakai yang higher bit, dia punya storage tu banyak makan lah nanti. And then kena allocate some space untuk GPX file. And then topo match punya, because yang 32GB ni is conclude semua sekali tau. So the watch itself require memory punya atau storage punya ni lah gap untuk dia buffer all this process. And then untuk music bagus, tapi setakat ni dia hanya support untuk MP3. Maksudnya korang kena either download and then masukkan ke dalam jam. Dan dia tak ada offline macam Spotify, Deezer, Apple Watch tu apa Apple Music takat ni tak ada lah, tapi ada MP3 saja. So korang memang kena transfer MP3 file tu dalam jam untuk dengar lagu.
Betul. Dan bagi aku pakai... pun nak cari MP3 pun susah sekarang ni.
Who use MP3 now?
Ah, itulah pasal. Exactly. Susah nak cari. For me ah, nak cari MP3 pun susah.
So, bring iPod and put the headphone in. I think that's the
why. Macam myself, I dah biasa dengan Spotify. Kalau you nak minta I suruh cari MP3, oh susah tu nak cari MP3. Okay, nak suruh carilah. But something good, good stuff in Koros. And then, okay, how to upload GPX file using apps or web? Ah, ini semua orang berjawab.
App lah.
App. Yeah, we use the app.
Koros no website one. Koros use app, everything on your phone. Very easy.
Correct. So, lagi satu kelebihan untuk pengetahuan semua orang. Bagi aku in Koros punya breakdown ataupun dia punya sistem semua ni, ekosistem eh. Dia pakai apps dia je. It's very fast. Macam contohnya, kita orang nak pergi race hari tu dekat Merapuh. On the way tu, aku tak ada GPX file. Aku minta member aku WhatsApp aja. From the WhatsApp tu, dapat GPX file tu, terus transfer, masuk file, masuk dalam apps, transfer, settle. Esok tu lari. Pakai navigation. So that is something yang bagi aku is very fast using Koros lah. How about any one of you guys? What experience do you have with GPX files?
Very fast. I think they fixed the bug a few months ago. You know, last time when you put the GPX file and then got no elevation. Now they fixed already, so no issue.
Yeah, I think so far my experience with uploading the GPX is no problem at all. Even for me, like sometimes I can just go on other runners' Strava and then just take their GPX and then put it in my phone and follow them. Yeah.
Apa ni? Oh, ini best soalan ni. Sekejap. Tiba-tiba pula ada orang tanya. Betul ke orang cakap kabel korang selalu hilang sebab bateri tahan lama sangat? Lama tak charge.
All the time. Always hilang.
Okay. Simpan baik-baik. Mahal kabel.
Ha, or you betul. Can use the keychain charger. Ada itu keychain charger, you know the new one, the small one.
Yeah.
And you cannot hilang.
Okay. Macam Abu Daifan tanya berapa aktiviti ada. Okay, aku akan tunjuk lah.
Ayo, so many.
Ha. Maybe you guys boleh cerita lah aktiviti yang you guys ingat sambil-sambil I nak tunjuk dekat dia.
Ada like windsurfing lah. Ayah tak tahu lah.
I only use a few lah. Like trail running, run, sometimes hike, bike, pool swim, open water, trail time. But what I like the most is
windsurfing.
Windsurfing. You can customize it. You don't need to display everything, you know, which is really nice. Yeah.
Indoor rower also harder.
Yeah.
Gym cardio, GPS cardio, ski, snowboard, cross country ski. Oh yeah, banyak lah. And then if you don't have, then you just put just normal cardio lah.
Yeah.
Betul. So even right now the Vertix ni dia made for rock climbing, macam-macam mountain climbing. Sekejap dia silau sikit. Okay, so best thing about Vertix ni dia memang full lah, everything you can use. Even for triathlete, because apa yang I dengar, triathlete pun suka pakai Vertix ni. Okay, tapi lah, there is one thing about
multi-sport up there.
Yes, ada multi-sports. So ada multi-sports, ada training plan, so aku boleh check ni multi-sports. So
yeah. Because sometimes if you do duathlon, then it's different from triathlon mah. So you put the multi-sport lah.
Correct. So, tapi benda yang lagi satu yang orang cakap ialah dia orang kata apa, tak ada, sekarang ni tak ada ANT untuk Vertix 2 ni. So dia orang dah keluarkan ANT plus ataupun N plus. So maybe Fendi boleh cerita sikit pasal N plus ni?
N plus, okay. N plus ni dia sebenarnya macam Bluetooth tapi dia boleh connect multiple device at same time tau. Maksudnya contoh hari kita nak cast dekat trainer, so dia boleh connect banyak device. Tapi bila dia dah buang ANT plus ni macam aku tak tahu kenapa dia buang. So untuk akan datang, kalau nak cari sensor kena cari yang memang Bluetooth support atau at least dual N plus plus Bluetooth. Sebab kalau N plus punya gadget semua sekarang ni memang dah tak boleh nak pair dengan Vertix 2 ni. So untuk yang Vertix 2 ni korang kena check dulu gadget-gadget korang atau gadget yang future korang nak beli. Pastikan ada Bluetooth dan juga N plus.
Okay, sambil-sambil tu ada orang tanya dekat sini, boleh customize apa watch face tak? Duka cerita maklumkan dia tak boleh customize. So dia punya watch face pun macam setengah jam lain, macam jam lain dia ada watch face dia, kita boleh letak macam-macam muka kita boleh, gambar kita boleh. So yang ini dia ada watch face.
I don't think you can put gambar. I thought it's just standard watch face.
Yang ini tak boleh lah. I mean for Garmin boleh tak silap I.
But Garmin mahal lah. You want to pay lah.
So macam that's why each ecosystem ada their own orang kata apa, kelebihan masing-masing lah. Tapi macam ini, one of the things yang I like about the thing is dia boleh pilih color juga lah, yang tu je lah. So meaning kalau nak sama dengan tali korang boleh lah ubah-ubah color, that's it lah for this thing. Meaning dia punya design tu sama dia punya watch face tu, cuma korang boleh tukar dia punya color, itu je lah. So that is something yang dia tak boleh buat lah, tak boleh letak muka dan sebagainya lah, gambar-gambar ke apa.
This is my favorite watch face, nothing one. Simple and easy.
Oh, clean kan?
Clean.
Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, apa ni? So seterusnya ada orang tanya, selama ambil ni dari Sarawak masih accurate lagi tak masuk hutan? Oh ni GPX kot. Ray, macam mana? What do you think?
Well, usually before I take, I also need to check the breadcrumb lah, because if the breadcrumb doesn't like go in the right trail, then I won't use it. So usually I just check the breadcrumb first, and if it's like you see it as a proper breadcrumb throughout the trail, and I use it on course, probably it's only like 10 to 20 meter, not the same, you know. Like it could probably also because, you know, that person used a different, because, you know, when you're inside the trail, there's a lot of route, right? So sometimes, but it's still going at the right way, you know. So sometimes when you look at, when you compare the GPX that you take from Strava and then the one that you just ran on, sometimes it's like 10 to 20 meter off different, but there was never a case that I use a GPX and it was it's not accurate. So far everything is quite accurate for me.
I think it also depends on the coverage in the trail, because if it's more forest, your GPX will never be 100% accurate. But this is all watches, because it's GPS is from ground to sky, right? So if you got lots of trees, obstacles, then obviously the GPS is not very good. So, but all the brands will be the same. So,
It could also be because of the weather also, because, you know, the person might run on a sunny day. I might run on the, you know, like thunderstorm or what, you know? So it's a lot of coverage is not that good. But so far it's okay.
Macam ni boleh ke dua Bluetooth device connect at the same time kat Vertix 2? Tak boleh. pasal memang dah cuba dah pun memang tak boleh. Macam aku ada 2 jam. Okey, ni perbezaan dia Apex Pro dengan apa? Dengan Vertix. So beza besar gila dengan kecil gila. Dia punya size ni 42, ni berapa tadi aku lupa. So memang dia besar lah technically. 1.4, 1.5 lah. And then standard what form, okay. Apa ni? Takziah Gamin. Asyik kena bash. Okay. So itu tak dapat topi lah. Itu takziah tak dapat topi lah. Okay. Anyway, sambil-sambil tu, pada korang yang tengah tengok sekarang ni, thank you. Boleh tanya soalan yang best-best, yang susah-susah bagi kita orang tak boleh jawab, bagi kita orang confused. Itu yang kita orang nak. Sambil-sambil tu, aku juga menceritakan tentang apa features yang ada dekat sini. So, lagi features yang ada, points yang aku ada ialah dia punya widget. So, sorry. Sebelum widget tu, widget tu biasalah kot yang tadi kita tengok. Aku nak tunjuk dia punya, sekejap kena pakai. Dia punya HRV. Oh, so siapa tahu apa maksud HRV?
Heart rate variability.
Oh, terror lah. Student yang bagus.
Is the, you know, when you're resting and when you're running, like what the variability is.
So ini merupakan HRV dia. So you just letak tangan macam tu, then dia akan calculate you punya HRV lah. So sebaik-baiknya gunakan benda ini masa bangun tidur. So dia vibrate ni sekarang ni. Actually dia macam tuk 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 tuk. So for your information, this is how you check your heart rate, HRV lah. Dan what's the benefit of HRV, Edison?
Help you train better, I think. I don't know, I never use also.
Tapi padu, ayo. Where's your dog?
Downstairs lah.
Ayo, I thought you nak bawa dia.
Yalah, wait lah. After you finish, I'll bring him here.
Your training partner.
Tak boleh lah, then cannot run lah.
Okay.
But I think it's promising for this one. Because you know, you never know in the future, they might collect the data and then, you know, translate it into a better result. Because right now they cannot track the data, right, for the HRV or the ECG, if I'm not mistaken. So
dah 53 dah kau.
Yeah, they can only tell you the stress, the amount of stress, right? So hopefully in the future they can, you know, create like track your data with it.
But sometimes one thing that I like about this is because they also have oximeter lah. So meaning especially right now with the cases COVID and stuff, so this is something that's useful juga lah. So we can check lah our oximeter. So tak payahlah pakai jari macam ni, Afendi, ya? Pakai pensel lah.
Pakai pen.
But I think the thing that you have to always bear in mind is with heart rate and HRV and things like that, if you really think there's a problem, don't rely on your watch, because as much as the watch is trying to be as good as they can, the readings are not accurate. So if you really need, if you think there's a problem, go and see a doctor. Don't rely on your Coros watch, because it's not built for that, right? So but HRV, if your readings are high, then you can also you might also be able to like see whether you're gonna be sick or not, flu lah, fever lah, whatever. So,
correct.
Yeah.
Usually, you
look at their symptom also, right? Because your heart rate can be telling you something, but when the symptom is like, you know, like when you're about to have like a heat stroke or a, you know, heart attack or something like that, there's another symptom on your body. So like the watch is just one of the thing that can tell you.
Okay, so like for this one, this is I just buka dia punya satellite, so it will take some time to read lah what kind of satellite yang kita ada lah. Macam so far Vertix 2 tak boleh connect earbud and chest strap pada masa yang sama. Ha. Saya tak ada chest strap sekarang. Kemudian earbud ada. Earbud okay. Meaning when you connect your earbud memang ada dia boleh ni. Chest strap Bluetooth juga. Sepatutnya boleh function pasal dia ada apa? Bluetooth ni boleh aje 2-3 benda sekali function. Betul tak Fendi?
Sepatutnya ya lah. Tapi tak tahu setting atau hardware yang Vertix 2 ni pakai aku tak pasti.
So memang apa sepatutnya tak ada masalah kalau macam tu. Dia notification dia pun ada. So one thing about notification Coros ni bagus pasal dia memang dapat kita akan dapat lah macam from the phone kita boleh pilih apa yang kita nak notification daripada WhatsApp ke Facebook ke apa semua. So you can choose lah technically. So yang tu boleh tengok dalam website dia orang tak ada masalah. For golfers okay tak? Ha, somebody boleh jawab tak? I bukan golfer. Fendi, main golf ah?
Don't have.
Tak main tapi tak silap tak ada mod golf. So
jam apa yang ada mod golf? Ada kan jam yang ada mod?
Ada, Garmin
Phoenix yang ada topo map semua ada. And then dia ada preloaded course. Ada preloaded course.
Oh, ini soalan berani ni. Jam petir semua nak beat Garmin Duro ke? 140 jam macam mana? Ha. So jawab sendirilah. How many years is the warranty? I got any if got any problem can change one to one is it?
Oh, oh no, ask Coros. But usually they are very good. I think I've seen a few on the forum. If
yes,
if
the response is very good. The support lah.
Yeah.
Correct. So tak silap I memang ada warranty dia 1 year ke whatever. Because I have a friend nama dia Kak Hanim. Dia pun ada problem dengan dia punya watch which is something I can't remember. But then cepat je ganti. It's orang kata the support is good lah. Kalau warranty tu tak payah risau lah. Okay, topo map sedia ada atau kena load sendiri dan free atau berbayar? Ha. Fendi boleh jawab tak? Aku tahu jawapan dia tapi tak apa kau jawab.
Preloaded dah ada and then in future dia akan tambah untuk local map. And then tak silap aku kita ada juga group yang create topo maps. Maksudnya dia buat topo maps untuk Malaysia so that in future boleh kot add sendiri. But jam ni sendiri dah datang dah preloaded topo maps.
Yes. So memang dia preloaded boleh tengok lah kat situ. Fuh, semua jawapan boleh jawab ni. Macam nak bagi topi? Baru satu topi je dilepaskan. For the others, for Ray and Alison and Andy, bagi sikit yang susah ke? Cik, nak bagi hadiah macam mana ni? Can we automatically combine two activities on the watch app in case tekan stop in between a run? Huh? Kau tak boleh jawab tak?
But got website you can. Got one website you can combine.
Betul. So that one is a different one lah. Maksudnya luar daripada kita punya orang kata apa? Kita punya ekosistem ataupun yang ada sekarang lah.
Yeah,
so boleh boleh combine je. Kalau satu buat kot.
Kena export activity and then combine the website and then kena import balik dalam Strava. Kena do in apps.
Feed file tools.
Yeah. Combine. Download and then import balik masuk dalam Strava and then should be work.
Alright. Okay. Ada apa-apa features tak yang korang nak tengok di dalam ni sementara sambil-sambil kita ambil questions daripada korang. Kalau tak ada tak apa. Sambil tu aku akan tunjuk satu gambar. Gambar sekejap Ini merupakan gambar. Okay, Coros datang, Vertix ni datang dengan dua warna. Okay, satu lava dengan obsidian ni. So dua ni ialah yang akan masuk. Dan juga ada orang tanya hari tu tadi berapa harga dia. Harga sebenarnya belum di-release dari Koros Malaysia, tapi aku dapat info daripada orang yang diorang akan bagi tahu dalam masa terdekat lah berapa harga dia. Okay. Kemudian dua pilihan ni, dan dia juga ada strap yang kita boleh ubah lah. Maksudnya apa, berapa strap apa untuk jam tu ada berkala-kala juga lah untuk pilihan kita. Alright. Other than that, macam tadi dah cakap pasal strap. Okay, harga dah. Okay, so mostly semua topik yang aku nak cakap telah dicakap. So sekarang ni tak ada peraduan teka harga ke? So, oh, orang dah dapat topi tanya pula peraduan teka harga kan, sampai hati. Okay, fine. Which model more value for money, Vertix atau Vertix 2? Hah, somebody boleh tolong jawab tak?
See what features you need lah.
See what features lah, tapi for me ni bagus juga lah, Vertix 2 ni bagus lah. Macam Effendi sendiri dalam banyak-banyak jam yang dah pakai, antara dua ni mana rasanya yang berbaloi?
Alang-alang Vertix tu kot, sebab features dia akan fully utilize lah dekat model ni.
Ray, how about you?
If it's for me, because I jump from Apex, from like Apex 46, I think Vertix 2 would be a good deal lah. Because if it's like a new watch that you want to get and you're looking for a premium GPS watch, definitely Vertix 2 right now is on top of the line. And you know, you just add a few more hundreds and then you can get the Vertix 2. Definitely worth it with the incoming things that maybe they can add to the firmware as well.
So like what they are saying, right? For me, macam tadi lah I cakap dengan Fendi, I like the knob ni because it makes you feel alive lah, macam you rasa apa yang you pegang. Because kalau macam a few watches yang everything is orang kata apa, pakai touch je, I think it's kind of susah jugalah from my point of view. Okay, from the others, what do you guys think? Do you prefer knob ke you prefer touch screen?
I prefer knob because touch screen sometimes, I don't know, I like knob better. But you know, because you have the map features, then having the touch screen will help you like to zoom in and zoom out.
Correct. Kalau tak susah juga kan?
Kalau tak susah lah. But what I like about it also, they, you know, like the watch itself, you can set whether you want to wear on the right or on the left.
Oh yes, lupa dah betul that one.
That one is really thoughtful lah when they design it. Because if not, then you know your hand will be pressing against the button.
Correct. Okay. Other than that, I think what else? Ada soalan lagi tak? Koros watch. Tu pakai kat mana? Kat Vertix biasa. Okay.
This one, I'm not so sure because the dimension is different. So I don't know if the carabiner.
Macam mana tadi?
Yang untuk mountain climb tu kan, rasa tak sama kot. Sebab saiz dia besar.
Dimension dia lain kan?
Yeah. Unless dia buat special untuk Vertix 1 ni, then kita kena tunggulah kalau dia ada buat. But for now, dia promote untuk Vertix
besar. Pasal ni besar. Dan juga the first 500 akan dapat buku.
Buku.
Okay, boleh jawab Cik? Boleh auto kacak tak kalau pakai Vertix 2 ni, Min? Ini you guys jawablah. So actually kalau nak tahu kacak ke tak kacak, you boleh tengok dia inilah. Okay, ini memang the default ataupun color yang yang ada untuk Koros, iaitu lava dengan obsidian ni, obsidian benda yang aku nak sebut pun susah. So Rino, aku tak boleh tekan Rino, susah lah tu. Okay. Bacaan SPO2 ada tak, Min? SPO2 ada?
Ada, ada.
Oh, tak nampak eh. Mana dia? Ada. Tapi tak apa. Yang tu memang ada. Yang penting ni sekarang ni aku just nak tunjuk dekat some of you guys. This is something yang I like to use before this ah. It's the metronome. Tapi Alison tak payah pakai. Macam
very annoying lah. Wah, pip.
Betul. Actually, last time when I used to go for running, my coach asked me to use this lah. Memang annoying lah. But I pakai
going to bomb like that.
I pakai earphone lah. I pakai that time pakai earphone lah, tak ada earbud. And then I dengar ini. Orang kata, you dengar music apa? I dengar this music lah.
So yo, people talk. Later all the cow chase me out.
But this is something yang for me is good lah, metronome, because it helps your cadence lah. Itu kalau you nak lari track ke whatever, it's boleh lah, no problem lah. Okay, so right now guys, I have talked all the points already. Now we need to choose the winner for the cap. I ada 4 cap lagi, so I need you guys to help out. Maybe you guys ask a question and they answer, we give a cap free for them. So think of some questions and then we ask the viewers right now, and then they jawab betul, we will give them the topi lah. So siapa nak go first? Okay. Jangan question tanya pasal yourself lah, tanya benda lain lah.
I have one.
Okay, so okay.
There's this one what do you call this? There's this one features. It's a new features that they have. It's a type of sports they introduced recently. What's the type? What's this the type of sport that is? Yeah, there's a new one. There's a new. What was the question? There's a sport features. There's a new sport features that is not been introduced before, and it comes with the book. It has something to do with the book.
Correct. I know what you mean. Huh?
And it's a collaboration between that one person, in US. Yeah.
Tengok ada jawapan tak?
Oh, dah satu.
Eh, cheating ah.
So betul. Mana dia? Aku tak jumpa. Multi pitch. Multi-page. So sungguh laju dan kenapa tak jumpa lah?
I think it's just like climb. Yeah, or maybe you haven't added to that.
Yeah, untuk pengetahuan semua orang, apa yang aku dapat ni, this is a beta version. Maksudnya masa I get it pun memang aku kena orang kata apa, install the beta testing and then baru boleh try this thing lah. So dalam Malaysia macam aku kata tadi, ada dua orang je yang dapat ni dulu, iaitu Al-Rumi dengan pelari denai dapat ni dulu. So that's how we are going to test it lah. Okay. So pemenang dia Ray ialah
Hisham Salehuddin.
Yeah, tanya Hisham, tolong DM pelari denai dan juga bagi details alamat semua, kita akan hantar. Bukan hantar jam, tapi hantar topi Koros. Okay, jam 3,000 kot, agak-agak. Okay, Alison, do you have any questions for the viewers?
Easy one. How old is Koros? When did Koros start?
Oh, yeah. I rasa susah, saya tak ingat. I sendiri tak ingat. Okay, when did Coral start? Sambil-sambil tu, Fendi tengah fikir soalan. Fendi, ada orang tanya, Abang Fendi, bila nak Lego jam? Ada orang tanya dah.
Nanti habis review.
Fuh, jawapan betul ke?
I don't think Alison. So.
Ah, don't think so? Salah?
No.
I pun tak ingat lah. Hoi.
Ah, correct. One correct.
One correct ah? One Agus only lah. Ini takkan nak bagi house. Banyak. So, the name is?
Wow, somebody put even the date lah. Wrong ah.
Wrong, that's me.
So, macam mana? Siapa menang sekarang?
Abu Dayan Firdaus winning.
Ah, Abu Dayan Firdaus. So, tanya Abu Dayan Firdaus. Alison dah bagi topi. Okay, so itu merupakan sejarah Koros. Okay, sambil-sambil tu Wendy, macam mana? Apa soalan yang nak diberikan kepada viewer sekarang ni untuk menang topi?
Berapa banyak model jam Koros ada?
No. Berapa banyak? Ha. Tolong jawab. Siapa ini tahu?
Yang baru launch juga ke? Apa ni?
Masuklah kan.
Daripada sekali. Awal sampai sekarang. Berapa banyak model dah ada?
Berapa banyak one. Model?
Wow, dia, dah ada pemenang ah.
Ada pemenang dah?
Oi. Oi, ramainya teka betul.
Ho.
Enam, betul lah.
So, pemenang yang paling tinggi, paling laju siapa?
Zul Rahim.
Zul Rahim?
Fuh, dah so, kita ada Phase 1, Apex, and then Apex Pro, Vertic. Tu, so, UK tu tak masuk lah, dia sama juga. Nah. Phase 2 jugalah punya kategori.
Kan? So, kategori sama tu tak aci lah. Sama dengan Icebreaker pun tak aci lah.
Ha. Tak lah. So, 6 lah.
6. Tahniah. So, Zul Rahim. Asal Zul Rahim ni selalu je menang? Yeah. So, jangan lupa DM bagi alamat dan kita akan hantar. So, ada lagi satu kan? Oh, ada lagi. Soalan. Map GPS tu boleh tak detect and show current weather tak?
Tak boleh.
Tak ada pun.
So far
tak ada.
Oh, tapi dia ada storm alert.
Storm alert based on barometric punya reading.
So rasanya kebanyakan jam sekarang ni yang mahal-mahal dah ada dah benda tu. Zul Rahim. Okay, so kita dah bagi berapa lah? 1, 2, 3, 4. So ada lagi satu lah. Lagi satu. Last but not least, apa soalan nak bagi kat diorang ni? Untuk bagi topi yang last ni? Ada tak? Bagi susah sikit lah, Alison.
Azam.
Ha?
Azam lah. Tak tahu lah.
Bagi susah sikit lah. Bagi nama your arnab ke, your rabbit ke. Something hard lah. Bagi soalan yang susah sikit for the viewers.
Sekejap.
Bagi I check dulu. Okay. Apa ni senang. Semua senang lah. Alamak, tak biasa. Okay. Okay, semua senang. Macam ni lah. I will ask a question lah. The question is, okay, soalan dia ialah untuk last topik koros yang nak diberi ialah berapakah jam battery life yang paling lama dalam Koros Vertix 2 ni. berapa lama boleh bertahan? Berapa jam dia boleh bertahan? Senang itu sebenarnya, tak susah pun. Aku dah bagi lah jawapan tu.
So easy.
Yeah, so easy. Ha? Paling lama, paling lama, ha? Paling lama. Bagi chance lagi, bagi chance lagi. Betulkah? Paling lama. Paling lama dia ialah standard full GPS every second plotting. Okay, sebenarnya dari segi sorry, yang tu bukan yang paling lama lah. Dia, aku bagi hint lah, bagi hint. Paling lama ialah Ultramax, sorry. Oh lama, ada orang betul lah. Ultramax. Pasal one of the things yang features best about Coros ni ialah dia punya Ultramax. Yang tadi kita tak bercakap, Ultramax ni dia akan orang kata apa, mengurangkan lagi battery usage lah. Fendi, nak cerita sikit pasal Ultramax?
Ultramax ni dia akan panjangkan sela masa antara GPS punya reading time tu lah. So macam basically biasa 1 second GPS punya reading. So bila Ultramax ni dia akan panjangkan, tak silap 60 saat ke berapa. So in between tu dia akan gunakan accelerometer punya calculation lah untuk distance. So bila GPS kurang pakai, bateri dia akan lagi lama lah. Tapi mode ni tak advisable untuk game yang perlu navigation terlalu kerap. Macam contoh trail running, kalau boleh lah, sebab Ultramax ni dia akan kurangkan apa ni, dia punya frequency reading, jadi takut navigation korang lambat sikit. So untuk Ultramax ni biasa kita pakai untuk game yang jauh, and then route dia tak banyak navigation ke kiri ke kanan. Kalau macam yang clear path and advisable untuk pakai Ultramax ni, okay.
Yang open lah, open space lah.
Open. And route punya navigation very clear, ada signage, dia boleh pakai lah. Tapi GPS punya bateri pun dah banyak. Ada ke event yang lama sangat? Perlu guna Ultramax ni. Rasa macam tak ada lagi kot kat Malaysia. So okay, rasanya 140 jam full GPS punya tu dah boleh habis tu satu event.
Betul. So tadi ada seorang jawab betul number dia, tapi dia jawab number saja, tak ada jam. So aku nak jawapan yang detail. So jawapan yang detail ialah betul, yeah, dia bukannya 100 lebih, dia 240 jam. So aku memilih jawapan yang betul, iaitu 240 jam dari Anna. Tanya Anna. Woo. So Anna dapat topi Coros, boleh PM pelari lain because jawapan dia 240 jam. Ada orang tertinggal perkataan jam saja. Alright, so itu saja. Terima kasih for joining this live session, because this is new for us juga, buat live sambil-sambil tu bercerita tentang jam vertex ni. So kalau korang ada any questions, boleh direct tanya ke Coros. Jam ini juga telah dibuka untuk jualan, korang nak beli. Okay, dan terima kasih kepada panel-panel yang ada hari ini, contohnya Afendi, Ray dan Alison Walker yang jauh di sana. What time is it, Alison?
3:25.
So before we leave, tell us more about yourself and what do you expect for, tengok pergi TMB tak? I baru nak kata.
Not yet. Not really.
That is what are you doing and what is your next target races?
I move up to the north part of England now. So very near the mountains and in the trails. The ground is very rough in Yorkshire. Very rocky, very muddy, very boggy.
So you are getting tougher lah over there.
I think so. And I spend a lot of time in the Lake District because I don't know if you know this brand called Innovate. So I'm working very closely with Innovate now. So I'm doing a lot of shoe testing, doing a lot of
Yes, innovate. Untuk mengatakan korang, Allison juga bekerjasama dengan Innovate untuk buat kasut yang terbaru, which is
Trailfly.
Yay!
But there are more shoes coming, so yeah, very excited about it.
Cool. Okay.
So yeah, my next race is in Scotland, so we'll see what happens there.
Yeah. So, how about your Spartathlon?
I don't want to run a road anymore. Boring lah.
So full time trail runner now.
I have no roads here, so yeah.
Ooh, okay, cool. Yeah. All right, Ray. So tell us, what are you doing right now, in this pandemic, and then what is your next target or races? UTMB ke? Hari tu dah pergi ke apa? Cappadocia.
Yeah. So yeah, I got a chance to go to Cappadocia in 2019. I think before the pandemic started, the last race was at UTOS, the Johor one, the one in Johor. And right now I'm just, you know, keeping myself sane. Now the park is opening back. So hopefully soon we can enjoy the trail. But yeah, hopefully the vaccination rate will also go a bit higher so everyone can enjoy outside, you know. But most importantly, you know, everyone to stay safe and, you know, avoid the crowd. Yeah, it's been, you know, I've been missing racing for quite some time, but, you know, health and safety is also number one.
Yeah. So what's your next target?
I honestly don't know yet, but probably if the travel restriction is still there, probably going to start working on PR project, probably, you know, enjoy the mountain around Malaysia, Selangor, trying to do, like, you know, explore more out there, because I know there's a few more mountain that I haven't run in Selangor area as well. So yeah.
Nice. All right. Last but not least, Fendi, apa buat sekarang dan juga apa target selepas ini nak buat?
Apa nak buat? Macam biasa lah, buat video, try educate user. And then cuba fitness tu sebab tadi kan, tapi just make a body ready lah, kot tiba-tiba suddenly kita dah boleh into the game and then just boleh masuk je lah. And then really hope that semua vaksin and then dah boleh cross state sebab Selangor tak banyak sangat gunung dia. And then kita pun tak boleh hiking gunung lagi kot. So
belum lagi kan.
Aku nak try feature sejam pun macam mana aku nak simulate, tak ada gunung.
Tapi kan korang, kita tak boleh pergi mana, tapi walaupun kita sihat, ada orang tu dia injured. Someone injured tapi dia lari juga sekarang. How's your injury, Allison?
It's okay. I got no ligament, so recover very fast. It's no problem.
It shows that you are tougher now.
Yeah,
so anyway, okay. Anyway, thanks again everybody. Terima kasih semua. Rino Irwan tanya, Ray asal orang mana? Takkanlah tak tahu.
Indonesia. Dari Padang.
Okay, ada orang tanya juga, Allison, ada discount tak Innovate?
But Innovate tak ada ship to Malaysia, what? You ask Key Power lah.
Yeah, ask there Canada. You go. Alright, apa-apa pun, thank you very much for tonight, the panelists also. Thank you and thank you everybody for joining in. Jangan lupa DM for the winners. It's a very good introduction for this new and latest watch from Koros, which is Vertix 2. And I hope to see lots of trail runners pakai dan juga have the benefits using this watch lah. Alright. So again, thank you so much for watching. Thanks juga for the panelists. And another thing that I want to remind you guys, we will have another session this week. It's about UTMB. So jangan lupa join Pelari Denai. We will talk about UTMB next session. So thank you. Good night, everybody.
Okay, thank you guys.
Okay, assalamualaikum. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.